Lonzo, how do you feel? How anxious are you to get this thing started? And how do you feel knowing that everybody's talking about how you have changed the culture of this team without even having gone through one day of camp?
I'm very excited to get everything started. You know, for me, everything starts kind of tomorrow, you know, in training camp. And as far as, you know, changing the dynamic of the team, you know, it's not just me. You know, everybody's in here working, all trying to get better.
Irvin said he thought you might be sick of all this. You're ready to play and get rid, finished with all the media stuff.
I mean, you know, I love y'all, but, you know, I'd like to just play.
What do you expect out of this team? What's the success for this season?
We're focused on making the playoffs. You know, obviously it's going to be a tough journey, but we're looking forward to it.
In the West, that's doable in the West? That's doable in this West? It's so competitive.
That's what I said, yeah.
Happy.
I think we can.
So what type of mentor has Magic been so far, and what have you learned from him?
I mean, he's the best point guard I ever played, in my opinion. So, you know, he's right up there. I can go see him whenever I want, and he's always, you know, willing to talk to me. So I appreciate him 100%, and I'm glad he gets to take this journey with me.
How about the physicality of the game? How do you feel you're doing for 82 games in this season?
I mean, I wish I knew, but this is my first year, so we're going to find out.
What's it like having Brandon Ingram back? Having Brandon Ingram next season, especially this coming season, coming back.
Oh, it's great, man. You know, B.I., that's my dude. You know, ready to go to war with him every night.
Luke was saying he wants to start a mentorship with you and Brian Shaw. Has he already started that a little bit with you?
Not yet, but thanks for telling me that. I look forward to it.
Lonzo, can you talk about the matchup? Who do you look forward to playing against? I know you've got a lot of talent in the league. Is there any one particular player or players you're looking to match up against?
No, I think he's got to come in every night, you know, focus, you know, especially playing the point guard position in today's league. I mean, every night is going to be a tough night.
Do you feel there's a target on your back since you're getting so much media attention?
Probably.
How do you deal with that? How do you process that?
Go out and do my job.
So how do you take this entire weekend and everything that went on socially with the NBA and the NFL? What was your take on everything that happened this weekend with the NBA and the NFL?
But, I mean, I really didn't pay too much attention to it. I was in there working, so that's about it.
Is there anybody in particular that you feel like you meshed with more in these workouts that you've been doing over this summer?
Definitely Kuz. I mean, Kuz is always in here, always working hard. So, and then I have a good chemistry. You know, we started building that in Las Vegas. You know, that's that all the time.
Polinka was saying he's already noticed a big difference with Kuz from summer league. Do you have any input to it, and what ways?
I mean, he's always in here working. Like I said, you know, he's always working on his game. He's in the weight room all the time. Definitely got a little stronger, a little bigger, and looking forward to playing with him.
Kind of summer, are you a vocal leader? Or are you just lead by example kind of guy?
I mean, naturally I lead by example, but definitely got to get more vocal. You know.
Brandon's not the loudest guy.
That's what I thought, but Brandon definitely stepping up in that area, and KCP's always talking.
Some of your teammates talk about how crazy things are around you. How do you keep that from them? How do you keep, you know, that from being a distraction to the rest of the team?
I mean, at the end of the day, we're all here, you know, to win, so that's all that really matters. As long as we just keep that our main focus, we should be all right.
Is the Facebook series going to sort of step back from you while you're in camp and while you're in
for sure, yeah. We're already done, you know, with the season, so. I'm finished with it.
No.
So you're not going to be filming anything during the regular season?
I mean, not that I know of. Right now I'm done, so until otherwise notice.
Are you glad about that? Was that something you put in your deal when you had to?
For sure, you know, get it done before training camp.
Magic said that his relationship with you is kind of like a big brother to you. Do you kind of feel the same way toward Magic, that he's your kind of like a big brother?
He's like an uncle. You know, more of an uncle. He's a little too old for my brother. So, I mean, I appreciate it.
What do you think, what has he given you most in your relationship? It's only been a couple months, but where has he made the biggest impact?
Probably off the court, you know. I already know most of it, but definitely, you know, he was in this too. You know, he came to L.A., all the spotlight was on him and stuff, so he's always helped me.
You're wearing a knee brace? What's happening?
Nah, just a swag pad I always wear when I play, so the other guys was putting on it, so I just put mine on.
Oh, okay.
What's it feel like to actually put on the full jersey uniform, be out from here to there? What's today's been experience been like?
I mean, it feels good. I mean, it looks good, right?
Yeah. Sure.
Oh, we could then. Yeah.
So what have you learned about your teammates with practice and working out together? Have you started to understand each other's games?
For sure. I mean, we have a very young team, and this summer everybody's been in here. So, I mean, kind of gave us a jump start. Everybody got to know each other early, and now we're going to training camp, and everybody knows each other. So. Definitely
is,
a plus.
What is it about Brandon that surprised you?
I thought he was quiet too, but he's not quiet at all, especially in the locker room. I'm on the court. He's always talking now, so definitely an improvement from him.
Magic was actually saying that Brook's kind of the key to this whole thing as well. You've been working out a lot with him. What's it been like with him and the connection?
Yeah, I got to play with Brook a little bit. He's been taking it kind of easy because of his back or something like that. But definitely very vocal. He's a funny guy. Always making everybody laugh. High spirits.
How exciting was it in summer league to come out of winning? And were your expectations high? And how much better do you think you guys can become and translate that into victory here?
I mean, anytime you play, you want to win. So we came in, you know, with a mindset to win it all. That's what we did. We came home happy. But we weren't satisfied. You know, it's just summer league. Got to keep working every day.
There were a lot of players that came in here this summer, Steve Nash, Kevin Durant. Mm-hmm. What are the other players that kind of came in here to work out with, and how cool is that to have them?
Yeah, I mean, KD was probably the coolest for me just because, you know, I watched him, you know, growing up, and he just won the championship. So it was pretty, you know, cool working out with him. And I thank him and Steve Nash for giving me the opportunity.
Is Derrick Rose in here as well?
I haven't seen Derrick. Maybe he was. I haven't seen him. I know DeRozan was in here, though. He's a great player as well.
Do you feel the pressure seems to be more on you than any Laker rookie in years? Do you feel that? Do you sense that at all?
I mean, I've been playing like this my whole life, so I really don't feel nothing, to be honest.
Even on a much higher level, even the whole...
I look at it all the same.
Same as in high school, same as in UCLA?
It's just basketball.
That's what it is at the end of the day.
You're just playing a game.
Game I love.
What is it like for you to kind of be given the keys everywhere you go, whether it's high school, college?
I mean, like I said, like, you get used to it when you play like this the whole time. Like I said, high school is the same thing, college is the same thing, and now I'm here, it's the same thing. So obviously, you know, the media gets picked up and the attention gets bigger, but at the end of the day, like you said, it's just basketball.
Are you interested to see?
The pressure doesn't really bother you. Have you ever been nervous on the basketball court?
Nah, for me, it's just always been a fun game. That's how I was brought up. You know, that's how I'm used to playing, just having freedom out there, having fun.
Are you interested to see how your body's going to hold up for 82 games? Is that?
I am. You know, I heard some stories, so we're going to see what the deal is.
Is there anything that you're nervous about at all coming into the season?
No, I'm not nervous. I'm just excited.
Are you able to go out in public anywhere anymore, or are you pretty much hounded everywhere you go?
I mean, people know me where I go, but it doesn't mean I'm going to stay inside all day. Say I get some sunlight sometimes in L.A., you know?
Do you have bodyguards?
Bodyguards? Yeah. I have, yeah, just one.
And the word that people use about your style of play is contagious, that the way you play is contagious to others on the team. Mm-hmm. Guys share the ball more because do you recognize that? This Lonzo effect? Is that something that you sense?
I wouldn't say it's Lonzo effect. It's just the way you should play basketball, I believe. And me being the point guard on every team I go to, you know, when I start passing, everybody else starts passing as well.
What's the biggest challenge for you in being expected to lead the team?
I think just the grind of the season. Like you said, 82 games. I never played that before. So, you know, it's my first year, so I don't know what really to expect. But I'm going in there with open mind, ready to learn, ready to get better, and just looking forward to the challenge.
Lonzo, can you describe the moment you step out on the Staples Center before all the fans? What do you think your emotions will be like and your adrenaline will be like?
I know I'm going to be very excited and just ready to play, man. You know, as a kid, you always dream of your name getting called. So I'm finally here. You know, just put on a show for the fans.
And talk about your fans, all the people that are following you everywhere you go, especially coming from Chino Hills and the Inland Valley. What would you say to that?
It's just humbling, man. I appreciate all of them. You know, I'm very thankful for their support.
The fact that there aren't high expectations when you think about, you know, playoff, everybody's talking about Golden State and those teams. Do you like the fact that that motivates you to show people that you guys are going to be a team that you reckon with?
I think it does. You know, always got to play the chip on your shoulder, and that gives them the chip. So I think it'll help.
How would you assess your game, defense, offense, court awareness? How do you think that you're prepared for that, the totality of your game?
I mean, I think I'll be fine. I've been playing basketball my whole life. I think I'm pretty good at it.
What levels or what areas do you want to improve in and just become better?
You can always improve in everything. You know, I'm a rookie, so there's a lot for me to learn. But I think the main thing is definitely my body, just playing as a grown man.
What areas in particular have you improved in already?
Been focusing a lot on ball screens, you know, this summer, just because playing point guard position, that's almost every time I'm on the goal.
Have you watched old tape of Magic Johnson playing?
My dad used to show me him all the time, so I've seen a lot of Magic Johnson.
Not since you've been here, you still
no.
Will you be wearing big ball green, or are you going to do the same thing in summer league where you might change shoes every day?
Who knows? Probably my shoes, though, thinking about it right now.
Have you gotten a lot of positive reaction from other players throughout the league about you trying to zoom
in? Not sure. That's something I got to look into.
Your teammates?
Yeah, for sure.
Are you going to be wearing your shoes for the game, for any game?
I'll definitely be in my shoes the first game and then just go from there, you know.
What was that all about during summer league, wearing different shoes every day?
Just showing people that I have freedom.
Has the team tried to modify your jump shot at all?
not yet. No one's touched it, so it's a good sign.
Lonzo, who's the inspiration in your life?
Definitely my mom. My mom, she's a strong woman, and, you know, as well as my dad, you know, she pretty much taught me everything I know.